two or three times bigger budgets. They've been like international networks, and usually we've been a partner of that kind of networks. I think the networks are very interesting model of collaborating. And the last network that we participated was a network called Cluster. And it brings different kind of spaces from London, Holon from Israel, then Kaskov from Utrecht and so on. So it was like six or seven spaces. And I like the format. The idea of this network was just nothing else, not to do anything, but just to visit each other. And when they all come to your city, you just present it the way how you work and the strategies that you are following. So we just, the idea of this network was, it was like 4 years project, just to learn from each other. And this was, I think, very successful.
And you have any kind of discussion or with local institutions, you negotiate, you don't negotiate, you hate them?
I think we talk, well, in Porto we have basically the Contemporary Art Museum and then Culture Gest, which is a medium-sized space, but as their base is Lisbon, they are very far away, you know? But I don't know, it's very different, you know? I think we are much more privileged than the museum, I must say. Because the institutions, they are so depending on the, you know, on the numbers, on the sponsors, so it's I think it's sad what is happening to the big museums. You know, they are becoming more and more like franchisings. So yeah, it's. The future is self-organization, for sure.
Yes.
I would just like to say something because it's, I don't know, well, what form can discussions, well, discussion can have very different forms. Although we don't like everything that happens in the Museum of Contemporary Art, and there's lots of big issues going there. It's true that the museums depend also on who's on the head of it and the relations they built. And I think that we, more or less, we always had the attention of people in the museum. Like they, once in a while, they go there and see what's going on, and they they care for us. Like. It's not about supporting or giving extra or money or whatever, but they pay attention, and we can talk openly about certain issues. And maybe it's a way to support. Like I can tell you that because I think that sometimes it's through anecdotes that we can really tell about what's. How things happen and what the weight of things. Last month it opened in Porto a show by the Spanish, Catalan, Brazilian artist Daniel Stigman Mangrané. And on the opening speech, the director of the museum says, "The first time I saw the work of this artist was in Porto in a certain lack of coherence." She says this on the open mic to, like, to everyone. This tells a little about what is the relation of the museum and our space. We have also made shows about with artists that have already had their retrospectives in the museums. So it's kind of, wow, we're hosting an important artist. So there's a certain exchange. It's not a direct exchange. It's not about a negotiation in the table, but things flow in a very Again, organic way, bio, fair trade.
Hola, hola. It's best, better because I speak not super loud. I have a comment and then a question. So I co-direct, or I've co-founded a project based in Barcelona, which is we could call it curators run initiative because we don't have a space. And so regarding the two last questions.